your word into your hand and let your spirit speak to us. Even now. In Jesus' name. Amen. Who is going to do the translating? See? It's all funny. Okay, Francis, would you help with the translation? Alright, we're going to read from Revelation chapter 12 this morning. This afternoon, right now, almost the afternoon right now. 我们要从启示录的第十二章看这个妇女. We are looking at this woman in Revelation chapter 12. And let's read these few verses together. 我们一起读这几处经文. A great sign appeared in heaven, a woman clothed with the sun, with the moon under her feet, and a crown of 12 stars on her head. She was pregnant and cried out in pain as she was about to give birth. Then another sign appeared in heaven, an enormous red dragon with 7 heads and 10 horns and 7 crowns on its heads. Its tail swept a third of the stars out of the sky and flung them to the earth. When the dragon stood in front of the woman who was about to give birth, so that it might devour her child the moment he was born. She gave birth to a son, a male child, who will rule all the nations with an iron scepter. And her child was snatched up to God and to his throne. Now, the Lord wanted me to talk about 5 different images of this woman, this today.
今天我相信主要我分享关于这个女人的5个不同的形象.
The book of Revelation is filled with signs and symbols, all kinds of figures.
在启示录这一卷书里面的，它讲到很多很多的预表.
And so we cannot just come at it thinking that we are just looking at a simple presentation. It is a multi-colored, multi-sliced, multi-dimensional presentation of the history of God's dealing through the Lord Jesus' first coming and second coming.
启示录是一卷非常非常复杂，很多很多不同层面的一卷书，讲到我们的主耶稣基督第一跟第二次。 在来时候中间神怎么样来对待我们的世界上面的人。
And you can see, you know, there's the narrative repeating itself, of the birth of Israel, the birth of the Church of Christ coming, and then the second coming repeating itself many times, about 7 times throughout the book of Revelation.
在这一卷书里面，你可以看见神重复了 讲到主耶稣基督的诞生，他的教会的诞生，和他再一次回来这几件事情，他重复了讲了好几遍。
And so from the book of Revelation, as we study it, it always gives more and more and more understanding.
所以呢，你看，你从开始看到末了，他越来越讲的比较多关于同一件事情。
But today we are going to look at chapter 12 in the women in 5 different ways.
所以今天我们来看第十二章，看见这个妇人和其他的5个方面。
So this great sign in the heaven, the singular, it's as though God is trying to tell us that it is going to be a very important spiritual sign.
第一节那个地方说，天上这个天上是单数的。
So usually the heavens, the skies, is in the plural, right? So right now, it's almost pointing us to think spiritually as we look at this woman.
在这个地方，不是讲到众天上众数，却是讲到单数天上。
So it's going to be deep in spiritual symbolism.
所以这个里面有很多属灵的预表.
And so this woman, clothed with the sun and the stars around her, standing on the moon, and it's also crying out in pain to give birth. And then there's a dragon that is waiting. This 7-headed dragon with 10 horns, waiting to devour the child as soon as it comes out.
这个地方讲到这个女人身披日头，脚踏月亮，她怀孕，但那个时候是临盘，要产案来了，旁边就一头龙等待这个孩子出生的时候要把它吞灭。
And this child was born, and this child will rule all the nations with an iron scepter. But this child was also snatched up to the throne of God.
这个孩子出生。果然出生了，这个孩子要以后做王，用铁架来统管万国。龙不能够把它吃掉，因为这个孩子出生之后呢，就从地上拿到就从地上升到天上。
So who is this woman? Well, first we can consider this woman as the nation of Israel.
这个妇人第一方面，你可以说她就是以色列国。
Because it is through the nation of Israel that finally, you can say this child that was snatched up to heaven, a picture of the Lord Jesus, and also of those who have come to a place who can be raptured up before the throne of God is birthed.
这一个妇人第一方面所预表的就是以色列国。这个孩子出生的孩子，你可以说他是预表耶稣基督从地上升到天上。和预表我们一起跟他从地上升到天上的一些他的子民。
Now the second is, instead of a nation, it is a real woman called Blessed Mary. Because that's what the angel gave to her, that you are most blessed woman. So it is Mary.
另外一个预表，这个妇人也可以说是神大大祝福那一位玛利亚。因为加百列就是这样子称呼那一个玛利亚的。
If we can say that the Catholic Church by and large has gone too much into even bothering on worship, and some do worship Mary, we should say that the Protestant Church has almost totally neglected Mary, and we don't esteem her very much.
若是我们说罗马天主教太注重玛利亚，甚至去敬拜崇拜玛利亚。你也可以说，其他的教会太忽略玛利亚了。
She was the most esteemed of women，
因为她是一个非常非常被尊重的一个女人。
She was a very holy, she gave her whole life to the Lord。
她是一个圣洁的女人，是主所拣选的女人。也把自己的生命奉献给主的女人。
She did not have an easy life.
她的生命绝对不是容易，其实很困难。
She carried the shame, possibly of an illegitimate birth, even the moment she is married to Joseph.
她一嫁给约瑟的时候，身上就带着这一个生下一个私生子这一个羞耻。
Who would believe the common people to think that God birthed a child inside her?
谁会相信你是圣灵叫你怀孕生下这个孩子呢？
And she followed this child as he grew up everywhere, bringing the rest of the younger children that was born to her later on everywhere, thinking that he went crazy at one point in time.
她就是把这个孩子从圣灵所怀孕叫他生下来，这个孩子跟他其他所生的孩子带他们去不同的地方，而且有一次他以为这个孩子疯了，因为他所做的、他所讲的、他所想的好像不合理的。
Can you imagine? By that time, Joseph had died, and Jesus was the, you can say, the head of the house now. He was the oldest, and he was a craftsman by trade. So he was supporting the family. And then suddenly, he had to just leave the family and go to a different city and started to gather disciples. So she had to bring the rest of the younger siblings and pack them up and follow to try and locate of this one side.
所以到了一个时候约瑟离开这个世界了，所以呢耶稣你可以说是那个家的长男长子，这个长子的责任呢就是照顾这一个家人的 但是有一天他突然间要出去服侍，离开家了，玛利亚没有办法，只可以叫一切一切的孩子们都要跟随他去他要去的地方。
She had to deal with the resentment of the younger siblings. And we see that resentment came to a point where in John 7, these younger siblings wanted Jesus to go and die in Jerusalem at the Feast of Tabernacles.
你也看见玛利亚所面对的就是耶稣的弟弟妹妹们都不喜欢他，都拒绝他。你像约翰福音第七章里面就看见那个情况。
And then she was the mother who had to come right before the cross to weep for her son, stripped naked, body broken up by many, many painful stripes, blood flowing down her swollen face and eyes being plucked out, and she had to be right there at the foot of the cross to see all that.
玛利亚也就是那一个母亲，来到这个十字架面前，看见自己的长子。经过这么多的虐待、痛苦、责罚，衣服被脱光，然后被钉在十字架上面，非常非常的痛苦。这个就是玛利亚，她就是这个人的母亲。
And she was probably the one who helped clean up the Lord Jesus. And then we see her also coming.Into among the disciples are in the upper room, the 120 in the book of Acts.
他也是在《使徒行传》第一章那个地方，他们在麻河楼上面，120个门徒里面的其中的一个。
You know, you can see a picture here on your right side of the Lady of Guadalupe. It is a piece of tilma shawl.That you put over your shoulders, that has this imprint supernaturally made about 482 years ago.
在482 years ago, from this, 四百多年前呢，就是有一幅图画，画着这个女人，她外面有一个外袍，是特别为她所画出来的。
This was given to a man called Juan Diego. As he was going up a hill in the middle of winter, suddenly he had an encounter with an apparition called Virgin Mary. But he was given this piece of cloth, and it's very supernatural, this piece of cloth. Even science will verify it.
就是有一个四百多年前有一个叫什么名字？
关爹爷，
在冬天，他走上山，他上山的时候遇见一个很奇怪的人，他就给他一幅图画，上面就是有这样子的一个图案。
不是奇怪的，是一个玛利亚的apparition。
Apparition, I don't know what that
means. Just an image.
Oh, an image. 一幅图画。
No, she came like a vision.
Oh, 好像一个
意象。But it's actually much more because she handed this piece of cloth to him to bring to the bishop in the city. Yeah, this young lady who is
就遇见一个意象里面那个女人，给她一个外衣。
Yeah. So anyway, you can read up on this. This piece of garment is supernatural. It should be disintegrated within 30 years. Until today, it's perfect. It's preserved without disintegration.
他就是给他一件外衣，这个外衣应该30年之后就完完全全烂掉了，但是还是存到今天。
So and on this tilma, this garment is this supernatural portrait that.You cannot reproduce it today with all the technology we have. You cannot reproduce the pigmentations and so forth on this piece of cloth.
这一条外衣或你可以说是一块布上面那个图案，直到今天也没有办法重复来放在这一个外衣上面。
They examine it scientifically and look into her eyes and look at the constellation on the right. Everything is perfectly set as to that particular day. So many, many things you cannot explain with just somebody trying to fortune painting.
若是你要看这个外衣上面那个图案呢，根本没有办法解释上面所写的事情。
So even the paint seems to be floating a distance from the cloth itself when they examined it carefully.
画在上面那个图案，那一些颜色，那一些油漆吧，你说，你可以说。根本没有办法知道怎么样可以放在上面。
You know, we should not argue theology. We just look at whatever is is.
我们就是看事实，我们不需要来辩论。
But what this piece of cloth did was to turn the entire nation around there in Mexico and turn all of them from all the foreign gods to the Christian God.
但是这一块布，其中有一个非常重要的目的。就是把墨西哥全国的注意力从另外一些偶像转移了，都完完全全关注在主耶稣我们这一位真神身上。
God allowed that piece of cloth to be given. God allowed this miraculous piece of tilma to be given to the people.
就是神容许这件事情发生，把这一块布传给墨西哥这一个国家。
And I'm very sure that because of that, many became Christians after that. Who many, even though initially it's like a form of worshipping of this cloth and the supernatural, over the years we know that out of that whole movement, many, many became Christians that we call born again.
就是透过这件事情的发生，神所容许的带领所发生的事情，很多很多墨西哥人就成为一个基督徒了。
And so we should not judge and say, "Oh, Catholic Church is bad and always bad. Therefore, everything is bad." We should always speak with a clear and fair mind on all issues.
所以我们需要，好像圣经说，不要论断。我们保留我们自己任何的论断。
God will be God,
因为神他是神。
Okay, the third possibility is this woman can represent the prophets of the Old Testament.
第三个预表，这个妇人就是旧约圣经里面那些先知。
And they were prophesying, they were describing, and they were crying out for the coming of this one who is born of a woman, born of a virgin.
旧约圣经那些先知都预言关乎。同经女要生的主耶稣基督。
Now there are three categories of prophet. Briefly, just to help us to understand the pre-literary prophets and the major prophets and the minor prophets.
在这个地方，我们看一看有三种不一样的先知。第一种先知就是在 pre-literary， 谁帮我翻译
？Before writing, they didn't write anything.
没有任何写下的记录下面之前的一些先知。也可以另外一个就是
Elijah, Elisha, and
以利沙、以利亚、
Nathan, these are pre-literary prophets.
都是这些没有圣经所记载之前的一些先知，然后我们有一些大先知和小先知。
Now, major prophets means that the writing are very long, and the minor prophets means the writings are very short.
小先知跟大先知就按照哪一项？他们的书卷上面的长短来定断定的。
Because some of the biggest messages are spoken through the minor prophets.
因为很多很多很重要的讯息是我们所称为小先知的那些书卷里面来记载下来的。
Now the fourth category, we can see, look at the women as the New Testament apostles of Christ.
第四个预表，你可以说。这一个女人，那个妇人所预表的，就是新约圣经那一些使徒跟门徒。
So they are continuing what the Old Testament prophets, as what 1 Peter 1 tells, they are continuing now to want to give birth to the church, to give birth to the body of Christ. So they are the ones, or we can say, is described in that woman.
就是这个妇人所预表的，就是好像。彼得前书第一章所讲的，也关乎主耶稣基督和所诞生的
来一个教会。So the spirit of Christ that already was in the Old Testament prophets that was causing them to speak about the birth of Jesus, this spirit is given in a fuller measure to these apostles, and then through them, the laying of hands and other means, the spirit of God is now birthed through into the whole church.
在旧约先知他们所领受的就是基督的灵。所以他们预表，他们就是预言到新约里面要来的弥赛亚。在新约里面，那些使徒呢，他们也领受同一位基督的灵，把这件事情传说的更加详细。
So they were actually filled with much more of the Holy Spirit and the Spirit that allowed them to also pass on the Spirit of Christ.The disciples.
所以他们所领受的圣灵是更有分量，充满他们，把这些事情也可以继续传递下去。
And so disciples, each generation then will be filled with the Spirit of God and will be maturing into the church.
所以每一代的先知，每一代的使徒，更多被圣灵充满。
And so the purpose is to.Give birth to a church filled with the Spirit of Christ.
这个目的就是叫教会更加来成熟。
To be filled with the Spirit of Christ.
而且要充满主耶稣基督的灵。抱歉。
Okay. Now, of course, the biggest symbol for us, and no doubt for God, is the Bride of Christ, the perfected church.
因为最大的目标对我们来说。就是那一个成长的教会或主耶稣基督的心腹。
And we must understand this much more than anything else today.
所以这件事情呢，我们需要更加明白的。
And so in Ephesians chapter 5, Paul talks about the marriage between a husband and a wife, and he presented Christ as being the one who is the husband who married the wife, the church.
所以呢，在以弗所书第五章里面所讲到的夫妻的关系，来预表主耶稣基督跟他教会的关系。
And he speaks of himself as the husband, who is going to wash clean, the wife, and lay down his life and perfect his wife until she becomes totally glorious.
这个地方就讲到主耶稣基督用他的血。用水把自己的心腹来洁净，叫他更加成熟，直到有一天他成为那个满有荣耀的教会。
And that church is called the Ecclesia, the called out ones, because they have been called Ecclesia, they are the chosen ones.
教会就是被神所拣选，从世界里面所呼召出来的那一群人。
You know, this is a very important truth that is not appreciated enough or not understood enough.
所以这一件真理是我们需要更加透彻来明白了解的。
The perfect bride will be picked and chosen by the Lord Himself.
这个完美的心腹新娘是主耶稣自己所拣选的。
And He Himself will.Be able to perfect this bride when the time comes.
时候到了，我们的主耶稣基督会叫这一个教会他的心腹得到完美。
And so that's his purpose, and that's the Heavenly Father's purpose to have a perfect bride for the Son.
天父的心意就是找一个最完美的新娘，嫁给他自己独生儿子。
And that's why when the Lord Jesus began his ministry, the Father gave him a list of chosen ones called the first disciples, the 12.
所以呢，当主耶稣基督在地上服事的时候，天上的父神就给他12个使徒。
And the Lord in John 17 said, Father, they belong to you. You chose them out of the world, and then you put them into my hand.And then I have given to them the word that you gave to me for them, and I have given your name to them. They were all chosen to receive from the Father's election.
在约翰福音十七章那个地方所说的就是主耶稣基督的祷告，父神是啊，把这个十二个使徒从世界上面呼召出来，赐给他自己的儿子。主耶稣就把父神所赐给他的道，赐给这十二个使徒，叫他们可以被他所使用。
And Jesus said that to the Father that I pray only for these disciples, not for everyone else.
主耶稣的祷告就是说，我为这一些使徒祷告，不是为千万人祷告。
And he also said that I sanctify myself, I separated myself for them, not for anyone else.
主耶稣说，我为他们把自己分别出来。
And the Lord also said, I want them to be where I am, and I want them to be one as I am with you, Father, one.
主耶稣也说，我愿意他们与我同在，也愿意好像我跟你天父合一一样，我愿意他们也是与我合为一。
And I want the love that you give to me, this same love to be in them as well.
也愿意把你所赐给我的爱，在我里面那一份爱，也在他们里面。
When we understand this, we will understand First John chapter 2 when it talks about be careful, you know, get away from the world and from the things of the world.
我们也会明白，约翰一书第二章那个地方要离开这个世界，脱离这个世界的事情。
The lust of the eye, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life.
不要爱这个世界，因为世界上面的事，好像，肉体的情欲、眼目的情欲和今生的骄傲。
The lust of the eye, what you see others have, even good things that you desire, which is of the world, which is of a temporary nature. Those are the lusts of the eyes.
眼目的情欲就是你眼睛所见到的事情，别人所拥有，你是贪这些事情，这个是眼目的情欲。
It could be a position, it could be some good food, it could be some jewelry, it could be some other precious things.
你所看见的事情可能是你的地位，可能是好吃的东西，可能是一粒钻石，或其他人所拥有的事情。
But you still haven't got it, so you lust after them.
但是你没有拥有那些东西，所以你就贪恋那些。
It could be even a retirement.
可能也是一个退休的地位。
You want to go to that place of retirement to enjoy life.
你想要退休。
This life.
我想要退休那个生活。
Now the lust of the flesh, of course, are things you have experienced, smell, taste, and everything that you have experienced.
肉体的情欲就是你身体所经历的一切。
So it could also be the jobs and positions that you have, all the wonderful cuisines that you just have to eat them all over, and you just fill yourself with all these things that you experience.
或是你可以品尝到很好吃的东西。
And so you complain whenever you don't have enough of a nice food or, you know, or whatever. So you have a spirit of discontent when they're not good enough for your flesh.
不好吃就埋怨，你要吃好的东西。
So we're talking about condition of the soul.
所以这个地方所讲到的就是我们的魂的情况。
Of course, we are allowed to enjoy the best of food and many other things, but they cannot have a foothold in our heart.
当然神是赐给我们上好的事情去享受，但是这一切的东西，一切的享受不能够掌握我们的心。
And so just as we are willing to enjoy ourselves this good food, we are just as willing to give this good food to another person to enjoy.
我们很喜欢来享受这上好的食物，但是我们也非常愿意把这个上好的食物给 Frank 吃，给其他人吃。
So we don't grudge when we give the very best of our food or our clothing or our best Bible away.
所以我们虽然拥有最上好的， 神所赐给我们的东西，到时若是我们要给他啊，我们要失去这些事情，或许我们要送出去的时候，我们一点都不会埋怨。
So even the most treasured Bible, if somebody needs it or has a use for it, you give it to them.
若是这甚至你非常心爱的圣经，若是其他人需要的话，你就把它送出去。
And of course, the pride of life is having to feel that you are somebody.
当然，今生的骄傲就是已经证明，我是骄傲。
And you know, you need your own space.
我需要我自己的个人的空间。
And so you don't like it when people intrude into your space.
当人侵入你这个空间的时候，你就不喜欢。
So that space is often your home.
这个事情呢，经常是我们的家里面的事情。
And oftentimes it's your time.
也可能是你的时候。
Your 时间。Your time.
时间。
Resource. And
你的资源。
And yeah. So these things that you say, they're mine, you know, so I don't want to share with you.
你可以说这一些东西都是属于我的，我不愿意跟你分享。
You know, the called out ones.Who are going into this place to be the perfect church will have to, as what has been shared by the different sisters, come out, Geraldine, and so forth. We have to come out from all these things that hold us back in the world.
就是我们的姊妹所分享的事情，我们需要从这一切所拦阻阻碍我们的东西，从这些东西要出来。
Because you have been chosen to come out from the world.
因为我们已经被拣选从这个世界里面出来的。
John said in 1 John chapter 2 that if these things, you are still among these things, and these things are part of you, then the love of the Father is not in you.
约翰一书第二章那个地方，若你爱这个世界，若这些东西都是在你里面，爱父的心就不在你里面了。
Well, actually, that translation that Francis just said is the usual translation of the Chinese Bible, but it's, to me, it is an incorrect translation.
这个华语的翻译是不对的。
And why I say that is because of John 17.
因为我为什么说不对呢？我的根基就是约翰福音。
Because we have to understand that in the Greek, it's possible to translate the way that the Chinese translation has, which is,if you are in the world, the things of the world are in you, then you know, you don't have the love of the Father inside your heart towards the Father. It can read that way.
是的，所以华语圣经的翻译是可能这样子翻译过去的。
But in the Greek, the other way, equally, that it is, it means that the Father's special kind of love, His love is not inside you. His love,towards you, that special favored love is not inside you.
另外一个翻译就是按照那个希腊文呢，就可以说神特别那个爱，那一种爱，可不可以说是阿嘎佩那个爱？
That's a different topic.
It's a different topic.
Yeah.
神所给你是对你的爱，不在你里面。
It's just like a special love that you have for somebody that you favor so much.
就是你因为爱那个人。对他特别喜爱那个爱
Just like among us, when you are very close with the brethren here, you have a very special love for these brethren.
就是好像你们有一群弟兄姊妹在一起，你特别去爱某一个人在你里面，就是那一种爱。
Because you share a similar heart.
因为你同样分享同一个心智。
And that's what John was talking about. It's really...What Jesus prayed about, Father, I want this love that you give to me, this exclusive love, to be given also to my disciples that you have chosen.
主耶稣基督的祷告就是愿意父所对他这个爱，也是在他的门徒里面。
And that's why in John 17, the Lord said, just as I am not of the world, they are not of the world. They have been called out by you out of the world. And because of that, they deserve this love from you. They can receive this love from you.
主耶稣所说的就是他们已经从世界里面被呼召出来。 也不再属于这个世界，好像我不属于这个世界，所以父神啊，愿意你对我这一份爱也存在他们的心里面。
Now you can understand why discipleship is so central to the work of the Lord Jesus.
所以你知道，门徒做主耶稣基督的门徒，是对主耶稣基督的事工是这么的重要。
And that's why you understand in his great commission before he ascended into heaven, he told them, "You are to make disciples of every nation."
所以主耶稣基督就是在大使命里面。最主要的目的就是叫万民做我的门徒。
As the Father has sent me, I send you now to go and call the disciples into this first family of heaven.
父怎么样来差遣我，我也差遣你，叫万民做我的门徒，进去这第一个家。
And teach them to observe everything that I taught you.
要他们遵守我所吩咐你们的一切事情。
That's why in the discipleship teaching, you will understand the words of Jesus that he emphasizes over and over again the need to stay inside his teaching, the need to abide, live inside his teaching. His word become our food, become our drink.
所以主耶稣基督非常着重他自己本身的教训，要吃他的肉，吃喝他的血。
And that's why it is not possible for Christians who don't have a much relationship with the teaching of Christ to really come into a discipleship.
所以呢，若是任何人跟主耶稣基督本身的教导没有这一个很亲密的关系，不容易做主的门徒。
If you are a disciple of Christ, you hunger and thirst after Christ, His words, His very life, His every action, all the time.
若是你做主耶稣的门徒，你所渴慕的就是主耶稣和他的话，他的生命，他的作为。
Because you know that only he can cleanse you, only he can wash me so clean that we can become his perfect bride.
因为知道只有他才能叫我们被洁净，成为他所要的那一个心腹。
There are many, many specific teaching, both from the Lord Jesus and his apostles, concerning his word, how it cleanses us and purifies us.
在主耶稣自己的教导和他自己的使徒的教导里面，给我们看见他的话语怎么样可以洁净我们。
So God has a purpose that is to raise this bride through discipleship. And with a purpose, he must have a plan.
所以神的计划就是兴起他的教会，怎么样来兴起呢？是他的计划，就是用门徒训练。
So when you have a purpose to do something, you must have a plan to be able to do that thing.
所以呢，若是你有一个目标，你必须有一个计划达到那个目标。
And so his plan for the church is to first raise up these first disciples and as apostles who are totally redeemed out of earth.In Ephesians 4, he has to bring those who are captive before to the world into his captivity and lift them up from the depths of the earth into the heights. Then he releases them back to the rest of the people as gifts to the people.
所以他的计划首先呢，就把这一些门徒，属于自己的门徒，从世界这个世界上面呼召出来，好像。被世界里面所捆绑的一些人释放出来，拯救出来，成为他自己的奴仆，带他们到天上，给他们给自己所改变更新，然后把这一些他自己的仆人呢，再一次赐给地上自己的教会。
So he said, if you read on in the Ephesians chapter 4, verse 8 on.He said that these gifts are the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, and the pastor teachers.
所以你看以弗所书第四章第八节那个开始呢，你就看见我们现在所称的五旬的集事。
So it's actually fourfold because pastor teachers are one in the.
哎，最后两个东西，最后两个职位呢是合一的，你可以说是四旬执事。
But these ones, you notice, are the ones who have already escaped from the clutches, the captivity of the world. These ones are the ones who have a heavenly standing.
但是这一些事情，这一些啊，你可以说是神所赐给我们的恩赐的这个四旬执事那些人呢，已经从世界里面一切捆绑都完全释放，他们是脚踏在属灵的领域上面。
So with only these ones who are disciples of Christ can perfect and mature the body of Christ.
所以呢，神所赐给我们这些四旬的执事。教可以是可以教教会可以成长直到、完全那个地步
Many parts of the church even those that grow in number do not mature at all
是的虽然教会有很多很多的人但是他们没有长进没有增长
It's because these churches don't have the gifts of these apostles, prophets, evangelists and pastors, teachers in their midst to mature them
因为呢 这一些、聚会点里面没有神所赐给他们这个四旬执事，叫他们可以成长。
Yes, they may go with the name apostle so and so, prophet so and so, pastor so and so, evangelist so and so, but they are men appointed positions. They are not the gifts of Christ.
他们可以被称为某某使徒、某某先知、某某牧师，但却是人称为他们如此的。不是主耶稣自己赐给他们的恩赐。
If you are a disciple who have been redeemed out of this world and have a heavenly standing, you will be a gift to the maturing of the church.
若你是被主耶稣基督从这个世界上面释放、护照出来了，你就是可以成为主耶稣基督赐给教会的恩赐。
Your fascination will not be with, you know, the world, you know, whether it's guns, you're thinking of politics, you're thinking of conquering cities and whatever, or about environment, everything to do with this world.
你的思想，你所关注的事情跟这个世界再没有任何的关系。
Too much of the church is in too much politics.
太多太多，我们的聚会的弟兄姊妹呢，关注在那一个政治上面
，about how to change government policies，
怎么样改变那个政府里面的一些措施
，about how to transform the cultures of the peoples of the land，
或许怎么样来改变这个地方不同的文化
，is that what the Lord Jesus really wants？
这个是否是主耶稣基督所要的
？And in the process, we become militant, and the extreme cases of the Roman Catholic Church, you know, they begin to take up arms and there was a Holy Roman Army sent by the Holy See, and many battles were fought.
就好像比较好像罗马天主教一样，他们极端到要兴起自己的军队去打胜战。
They want to win this world for Christ by military power.
他要赢得这一个世界，是用他们自己的武力来成就这件事情。
Or sometimes we want to win people groups. In the name of Christ to the church, we use all kinds of the worldly ideas, rock music, or interesting events, just to draw them to come to so-called become Christians and come to church.
而且他们会使用世界上面不同的媒介、不同的方法，叫人来成为一个基督徒。
You know, disciples are found one at a time.
但是呢，门徒是怎么样形成呢？是一个一个
Look at how the Lord Jesus himself did it.
我们看看主耶稣基督怎么样落成这件事情。
And look at how the apostles continued that.
而且要看一看我们的使徒们怎么样来落实这件事情。
You know, the Lord Jesus wants us to really bring him to become the gifts ourselves to be brought.To be in His hands, to be given to the church.
主耶稣基督愿意我们每一个人都在他的手上，成为一个他可以使用赐给教会的恩赐。
At His first coming, of course, he had to situate it among shepherds in the field, and also among these wise men called kings, and also the local king, Herod. So he was situated in the midst of all these different important personages.
所以主耶稣基督降生的时候，我们看见有牧羊人在夜间， 有一些做地上的王，也有一些是门徒在那个地方。
But what he really wants when he comes again is that these shepherds and these kings are real kings and real shepherds and real leaders, and they are gathered in his hands, from the world and into the heavenly. What he really wants is to give gifts back to the church, to build up the church.
主耶稣其实的心意就是愿意他来到这个地上的时候，他要这些牧羊人这些王是真正成为属灵领域里面的牧羊人和王，他可以带上他们，要把这些成为他手上合用的器皿，成为教会里面的恩赐。
This gift will come and beautiful this most lovely of child, which is going to be his bride.
而且这些人来到这个地上，要使一个很起初开始成熟的教会，慢慢成为最完美的教会。
Yes, the Lord will have His perfected bride in His discipleship family.
主耶稣基督有一天会得到那一个最完美、最合他心意的教会，就是他的心腹。
And this bride will come to reach unity in the faith and knowledge of the Son of God.And will come to attain the full measure of God Himself.
这个心腹就会成为长大成人，认识主耶稣基督神的儿子，成到那一个基督长成的身量。
So we must all understand this and move towards this goal.
所以我们要首先明白这件事情，朝这个方向去行走。
So no matter who we are here in this church,
所以我们在这个教会里面
no matter your abilities or your knowledge of things or of the Bible at this point in time,
现在你的情况如何？你认识圣经多少？
But you who are willing to respond to this calling of God to come out of the world and to be learners of Christ, you will be brought to maturity.
我愿意你们听到这一些话，神要把你们呼召出来，神要愿意你成为他的门徒，神要愿意你长大，神要愿意你成熟。
You must be willing to step out to respond to this call.
你必须向我们的主耶稣有一个回应。
You must be determined to be a true disciple of Jesus.
你心里面一定要决定，我要做主耶稣基督的门徒。Amen.
And if you do that, He will ensure that you will be perfected.
若你愿意的话，主耶稣就叫你得到你的目标。
Because His plan will never fail.
因为他的旨意，他的计划必定要成就。
It may take longer.Than he had wanted, but it will be fulfilled.
时间长或短，我们的主的心意必定要达到。
Jam has a part, not only to mature from within.
我们众人必须要成长、成熟。
I'm talking about this congregation, Jam. There is a part of us that needs, there's a real part.Of our community that we must keep maturing into Christ.
就是我们自己每一个人在这一个团体里面，我们都必须一起来长进。
So we have a portion in this maturing.
所以我们在这一件事情上面是有份的。
But we also stand also as a gift in the hand of the Lord towards the nations of the world.
我们也愿意成为神手中的一个可以他所使用的一件礼物或恩赐，对万国万民成为一个恩赐。
Yes, there are others whom the Lord have raised up into the heavenlies also to do the same for the rest of the church.
所以呢，我们也知道其他弟兄姊妹也被主耶稣自己呼召成为同样的恩赐。
Not all.The church, not all the brothers and sisters, specific ones in every part of the world that the Lord have already brought to a place of gifting. And these the Lord is releasing to the church.
就是主耶稣基督 在不同的地方所兴起所拣选自己所使用的，在万国来成就他自己的心意。
We must take this calling and this last day's commissioning very seriously.
我们非常要看重这个呼召，这个使命。
We must come to the knowledge of the Son of God.
我们需要认识神的儿子。
And that's why in all our learning and meditation, we are focused on learning from the Lord Jesus.
所以我们要集中从主耶稣基督本身的教导。
We are focused on learning what the Lord Jesus learned himself from the Old Testament.
我们也看见主耶稣基督才从旧约圣经所学习的事情。
So he too had to live by every word of the Hebrew Bible. That's what he said when he met the devil face to face.
他自己也需要遵行旧约圣经里面的每一句的吩咐。这就是他向那个恶者要声明的一件事情。
And he continues after his resurrection to come to his disciples to show himself more clearly through all of scriptures.
他从死里复活之后，他也是向他的使徒、他们的门徒显现，叫他们更加明白他自己的心意、他自己的身份、他自己的丰富。
And for us, he is coming to take us as well.Through all the scriptures, through Moses, through the prophetic books, through the other writings. And so we are going through all those Old Testament because he is showing us himself.
我们也需要从旧约到新约透透彻彻地认识我们的主耶稣基督，进去他的丰富。
So it's not that we need to, the Chinese was translated, but he is taking us. That's very important to remember.
他根本就是要做这件事。
So what we are doing now is, his spirit is leading us as a church through the scriptures of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms.
圣灵就是把我们带进去，透过经过摩西他的先知和旧约圣经的每一卷书。
And that's why we look back the last few years, that's what he has been doing.
所以我们往后面看的时候，我们就看见啊，主耶稣果然是这样子做。
So for Gem, I'm not talking about every church. I'm talking about for Gem, we are moving according to the plan of God to fulfill His purpose.
所以我们这一群人，就是我们愿意主带领我们，透过他的旨意成就他自己的心意。
So you must take this very seriously if you believe in the Lord.
所以你若是相信主耶稣基督的话，你就必须看重这件事情。
So don't treat it lightly. Don't place yourself as just, just like everybody else.
绝对不要轻看这件事情。
You have a call, a specific call, and you have to respond to that call.
因为你和我都是主耶稣基督所呼召的，我的盼望就是你每一个人都要回应这个呼召。
Let us pray.Our Father in heaven, we come before you once again in the Lord Jesus Christ.
主啊，我们来到你的面前，透过主耶稣基督的名字。
He is the one who will perfect us.
主啊，你就是叫我们可以完完全全得到成熟的。
But he has raised up for the church the apostles, prophets.The evangelists, the pastor teachers who are recaptured from the captivity of the world into slaves of his and then distributed as gifts to the church.
主啊，你自己赐给我们的就是这使徒、先知、传福音的牧师跟教师，叫他们被你完完全全得着之后，他们就是成为你的奴仆。你就把他们赐给这个世界上的每一个地方。
Father, we ask that you will raise up Gem to be the gift that you want in your hand.
主啊，我们愿意你兴起这一群人，Gem，成为你自己手中所合用的器皿，成为你自己的心意可以成就在这个地方的每一个人。
Lord.Thank you that even though we are still on this path of maturing in you, you have you have already begun to use us as a gift from your hand.
感谢主，你既然在这个地方动了你的善工的时候，你已经把我们朝你手中所合用的来使用我们了。
And so, Lord, we pray, whatever end time work we have, that our participation in maturing your church at large is a very concrete, a very real one.
主啊，你在这个末世的时候，怎么样来使用我们？愿意你继续来使用。
So not just only as a church, on a broad platform like Angel TV, but as individuals as well.
不单只我们团体来使用我们这个团体，主啊，你也个别使用我们每一位。
So raise up in this church, many who are apostles, prophets, evangelists, pastors, teachers.
愿你兴起在我们的当中的使徒、先知、传福音的牧师和教师。
Because in our extended circle of family and friends, there are many Christians who need to be matured into that perfect bride.
因为我们还有很多弟兄姊妹，我们所认识的，他们需要听见这个呼召，他们也需要成熟，他们需要长成。
But Jesus, I pray that you will give everyone here a courage to dare to be a gift in your hand.
主啊，愿意你赐给我们众人都有这个勇气，愿意把自己交在你的恩手，成为这一个你所使用的恩赐。
Lord, we do not have to deal with the issue of pride or self-promotion.
主啊，我们不需要在你为我们自己有任何的盼望，自己有什么名誉。
But like Paul, we want to be able to say we are just your bond servant, your slaves.
说我们愿意好像保罗一样说，我们就是你的奴仆。
And we want you to be magnified through our lives.
主啊，愿意你透过我们的生命要被高举。
Thank you, Lord, for being patient with us.
感谢主对我们一切的百般的忍耐。
Thank you, Lord, forgiving us countless times our failures.
哇，主啊，谢谢你这么多次来饶恕我们的跌倒失败。
We need you every moment and for every task and in every situation.
每一刻，每一个情况，每一件事情，主啊，我们需要你。
And we trust in you that you will supply what we need.
我们相信，我们信任你会供应我们一切所需要的。
Thank you for hearing our prayer.
谢谢我们向你的祷告。
In Jesus' name.
奉主耶稣基督的名字。
Amen.
Amen.